Her elevator is currently broken. So, you know what? I got heat yesterday. People were like, why is it always bad news? Well, we're in a depression. Let me see. Jordan, I have some stories right here. Can you read off what these stories are? And maybe they make them look like good news. Tell me that's...
This is mean, actually. Expedia bookings down 90% from last year. Like, this is actually torture. Someone who works in the airline industry and travel industry, people are getting RVs. Here are the states where the end of 600 employment checks will hurt the most. California, where we live, where I'm trying to survive. Dunkin' Donuts could close 1,500 stores worldwide. It's not even a bad thing. There's your good news. Okay, Dunkin' Donuts.
And then last but not least, the dollar.
U.S. dollar suffers its worst month in a decade.
Good news. It's all good news and all the time. But in this video, I got 7 things in under 7 minutes. And let's begin.
This is what he does. All right, now it's time to get into it.
Welcome back, where it's all bad news all the time. But if you like a channel that goes over breaking business news and stonks, because that is good, right? Trading equities. I like it. Make more money at the end of the day. Start businesses at the end of the day. Stop. I mean, if you work, that's cool. I like working. I still work. Work every day, 24/7. But if you like this stuff, would you at least consider subscribing? So here's some good news. Expedia. The bookings are down 90%. What the frack? Okay, let me turn this into a good news story. Gentlemen, you're gonna be saving a lot of money this year not having to take your wife anywhere. And how is it that their stock is only down 6%? And Alphabet, you tricked me. And this is a terrible chart. All right, let's do this. Let's take a look at Expedia. And I've probably had to look away from the news over the last 10 years, probably 2009. I was like, wait a minute, nothing is correlating here. And I had to ditch news, although it helps, you know, it could give you a catalyst. But when it comes to how I trade equities, it is 100% charts. That's it. Just call me an algorithm. And let me make myself invisible because my hair is getting in the way. When I look at Expedia, I'm like, do I want to buy it? And it's actually a buy. That's what's just so crazy. The only thing is I don't like that we're under the 200-day moving average. We are an oversold, and we're turning around on the MACD. Okay, so even with like 90% down, and even if I were to zoom back here to like the beginning of April, these are lockdowns. And it's, look at this, just driving higher. And right about now is a great time to say this is not financial advice. Never listen to anything that I ever say. You will lose all of your money. Close your laptop, throw it out the window. If it's a desktop, throw that out the window, make sure it goes into a pool, flush the pool, never to return to the internet. But look at this, earnings call just released. Surprise, we make no money, 90% down, and we have a reversal. And being a high school business teacher, I used to teach things like this crazy thing called a earnings, where they actually make money, priced earnings, PE ratio. I'm like, all right, kids, never buy a stock unless the PE ratio. Nope, F it, forget it. That is not what drives the markets, has not driven the markets for over a decade. All right, so let me just get rid of the things that actually matter in a company. I'm so sorry, you guys. But this could be a possible trade, possible. It's not everything that I want to see in a trade. We're talking about Expedia. I'm taking a look. I probably want one right there. Also, I do offer in the link in the description, like this stuff where you're like, oh, let's turn on this and see where we buy and sell and how, you know, how does this all work? Link in the description. I give you guys $800 off. It's because I'm currently filming and I only allow about, you know, so many people in. The codes usually, it'll say, if it says 1,000, you missed it. So you got to turn your bell notification on and get it that way. And then if you missed it for the $200, you could just wait till tomorrow and pick it up there. Just please don't hate me when I start increasing the prices. When I'm getting close to finishing the course, that's when the prices will start going up. Because like with everything, you look at things with value. And when the price is low, you're like, oh, it must not be valuable. And I hope you don't mind. I just wanted to take in a quick little peek at Google. All right, here's our reversal. And I'm just curious to see, because on this reversal, everything looks promising. Well, except for being under the 200. But when I see that thing move back up, might be some opportunities. But for me, Google is a wait and see. We're close. It might happen today. Wait, it's today Friday? It's probably going to happen. Maybe after hours. Webull. Webull allows you to trade after hours. I cannot tell you. Robinhood? No. Run away. Run over to Webull. You need to be able to trade pre-market and after the market closes. I will tell you, I think there was a study done. The amount of money that has been made pre and post destroys during just regular hours. And here it is, full extended hours trading. Webull supports full extended hours trading, which includes full pre-market, 4 a.m. good morning to 9:30, and then 4 p.m. to 8 p.m. So if you guys are serious time serious, here's like, for example, Apple. Look at this gap. Look at the gap up on this right there. Gap up. That's like when the market was closed. You're like, oh, I don't know. Should I put? And then it's up here. Like you lost out. But Webull gives you two free stocks. I will leave a link in the description. And if you look down here in the bottom left, look, 7:30, okay, 7:31, get all the way up here. Look at that. And also my course is this. We focus mainly on Webull. I mean, you guys can use whatever brokerage you want. And we use TradingView. So those are the two platforms. This is super technical. And then we move on over and we go Webull and we make our trade there. But hey, Robinhood kids, it's time to put on your adult shoes and join Adult Bull. And I am back, coming in from Reuters. RV shipments surge. I could have never imagined this. RV shipments surge as Americans opt to carry home with them to avoid airports and hotels. What a paradigm shift that we have gone through, that we are witnessing. And these things last for decades. So people are like, oh, V-shape. Well, the V ends up going in a different direction into a different industry. And you guys need to think business-wise, since everyone's buying RVs now, what do they need? What problems are there? And how can you solve that? Now, for me, I've done that. I packed the whole familia into one of these things. Oh my gosh, talk about I'm gonna die. You know, down the coast we went. I'm trying to gas in these things. That's just not me. Gentlemen, you know, I'm simping out on this one. I can't do RVs. But to each his own, right? But by contrast, shipments in April were down more than 82% from a year ago, and then 30% in May, and now it's just a taking off. I actually do have a little bit of jealousy, though, as I'm going down the coast. I live in Southern California. I see all those RVs, and they're all, you know, hanging out, drinking right on the beach. I'm like, man, okay, you guys got something there. I think I need to change the way I think. It's happening, though. I do. I'm a dude. You know, us dudes, we don't want to change, but it's starting to change. And I'm going to disappear for a second for our next story. This is where that $600 is really going to hit. Here are the states that are really counting on that $600 to survive. And that's starting right now, right? It's gone. Couple minutes left. Income replacement rate of unemployment benefits. And this story is coming out of Bloomberg. If you're wondering where expiring $600 unemployment checks will hurt the most. And it all just has to do with the cost of living. Depends on where you live, because I'll tell you, out here in Southern California, and I, you know, talking to my high school students, we go over budgets, and I'm like, how much do you need to make to survive without dying? And they're like, yeah, probably minimum wage. I'm like, okay, let's figure it all out. And then when they finally do crunch the numbers, they're pretty much freaked out. And I would tell them, all right, kids, so listen to this. I live in a condo. No big deal. As a high school business teacher, I make roughly $100,000. My wife does very well in the medical field. So you can actually be making $200,000 living in an apartment, screaming at your kids to turn the lights off or why is the air on? I mean, look at this. I went on to Realtor. I love Newport Beach. I'm a surfer, dude. Look down here. You're not even on the beach. You're not on Balboa Island, nothing. You're by a freeway. You got a little, what is this? You're a whopping 1,000-square-foot home for $2.4 million. And here's your street view. This is what you get. You get trash cans, sick garage, right? There you go. I mean, how far away am I from the beach? Like, do I see any beach that way? Do I see any beach that way? Anywhere? Hello? Beach? For almost $3 million? But the good news is you got a freeway right next to you, right? And oh, look, it's a smart and final. But you're like, Johnny Bravo, why are you in California? You're paying a tax rate of 100%. Well, the problem is I want to move where you're at. Where there's a nice, you know, lake or something, water or a stream, I can go fishing. But I have six flipping kids. And most of them are married and they're going to have grandkids and I'm kind of stuck. I mean, I'm also a high school business teacher, so I can go, you know, other places. But at the end of the day, you know, the family, yeah, it's a struggle. But from Bloomberg again, people fear they've got too much cash in their bank accounts. Falling interest rates are tempting some Americans to forego safety and pour their savings, guess where? Into stocks and Bitcoin. All right, that's a tough one. I love Bitcoin, but whew, way too much risk for me. I mean, what are the chances that we have some crazy blow off top? High likelihood, but I do not trade on news. I don't trade on this stuff, no. La la la, I trade on technicals. I look, I follow little lines and I get in, I get out. I take my beans off of the counter. And then I go buy a nice fishing pole so I can come fish with you. And it must be so frustrating. I'm not rooting for doomsday, he said, but you have to keep searching for yields. That is 100% correct. And then you see things like Facebook stock up 8% today. Gold, I like that one. The shiny stuff, I buy and hold all that. But I do trade the derivative occasionally, which I was looking at a trade last night on gold. Let's see what's happening. And I'll show you live right above my head. Can you guys see that? Okay, so on the MACD, we're starting to cool off. All right, we just came from way overbought territories. Let me move this. Yeah, because I saw this, right? Oh, and I'm like, give me a reversal, but we can't seem to get above that, my nine. So at that point, and even when I turn on my trading system, there is no buy to be made. So we will just have to wait and see. That's how stocks are. It's just wait and see, pick up the good stoof. The good, just not the bad stoof. Just that's a good one. And I could sit here all day long. I'm just going to watch that. Come on, buddy. Get over there. Oh, are we there? I want a full candle body close above that little red line. And let me disappear and show you. Look how far off our price action is from the 200. We are way above. Look at that. Ooh, rocket ship time. Stairway to money. And Dunkin could close 1,150 global locations. I'm going to make myself a little smaller. Oof. So with my dog, how many times, men, right? That's just the problem we have. Gotta just make myself smaller. My daughter comes into the studio and she screws everything up and then I gotta come in and refix everything. The company is working with operators to close low volume, low profit restaurants, including 800 of these bad boys. I don't like Dunkin' Donuts. I don't get it at all. They say their coffee's good. I don't know, I don't drink coffee. I know, you're like, wait, what? You have so much energy though. But there's a reason why you don't see a single person outside Dunkin' Donuts or inside. I hate franchise too. I've owned brick and mortar. And also I need to say something. Yesterday's video, I'm like, you need to start a business. And I offer a course on how to start a business on Amazon. I'm not saying do this stuff, not that business. Brick and mortar sucks. I hate it. I've hated it for over a decade. I've actually hated ever since I owned brick and mortar. I don't like it. Too much responsibility. I would rather come up with a product like this. You're like, wait, that's Bitcoin. Yeah, a fake one. And sell it online for 10 bucks. No one else does. And make 100 bucks a day. Something like that. I mean, I'm not saying that you will. But if you want to take a look at the course, I also offer 800 bucks off on that. Or even more. It's like 197. Crazy. That is like my college class all into one. But yes, there's only three or five codes on that one. So those go fast also. And my methodology in life is get a job. Okay, cool. Get a degree if you would like one. That's your call. I've been preaching no degrees for over a decade, and I can't tell you how many times I've been yanked into administration, like, is this true that you say don't go to college? I'm like, well, it just depends on what you do, but get a job. Okay, so that sustains you. And then you start a business. Oh, it does that. Not too much risk. You don't want to go all in. Just enough. I'm not saying like Dunkin Donut and have a franchise that's going to cost you $1.5 million and you have partners. I'm not saying that. Just something small, like selling Bitcoin, okay? And then from there, you take that profit and you learn how to trade equities. That's why two of my courses, that's why they're designed that way. I practice what I preach. This is what I do in my life. And every single year, I start a new company, a new corporation, a new side hustle, something to bring in more of the beans so I can actually pay my bills. Because as some of you know or don't know, we are in, do I have a dollar laying around? I do. This thing, right? This currency goes in that direction every single day. It's a sheet of paper, comes from debt. Debt is, there's no such thing as money. Well, except for gold. Gold's money. The rest of the stuff is just debt. They create a bond, which is debt. Has to be paid back with interest. So you guys are on this hamster wheel like, oh, why do I have to work so hard? And actually, in tomorrow's video, Dr. Wolf is going to talk about that. I'm like, I know, right? And it just keeps the top 1%, the wealthiest, and then the working people like you and me, you're out on the streets. You know what? Oh, and you're like, oh, can I please, government, have a few more $100? That UBI looks really good right about now. And no one understands what is happening. But let me tell you, you can't stay in the same place. There's no way. You need to learn these things. Otherwise, you're not going to make it. And that's what I teach my kids that keep coming into my studio and bugging me. Like, you need to start businesses, side hustles, learn how to make, right, McKenna, would you agree? You have to start a business. Do you like?
Absolutely.
Okay. Anything else you want to tell the audience while you just wander into the studio?
Peace out.
Okay.
No, I'm really coming in because I want to see if he wants to go get lunch with me, since this is all he does with you guys.
Nonstop in the Bravo house. Here we go. Yes, I do. I like working. I like you guys. I like you a lot. I wish I could hang out in the comment section all day long, but then I can't film videos. Markets, US dollar suffers its worst month in a decade. Okay. And I've had people on dollar milkshake theory. Johnson, that was good. He thinks because there is debt all around the world, everyone owes 1 trillion of what? My dollar's gone. Of the United States dollar, that little debt note, they all have to pay it back in dollars. So he thinks that over the course of, well, until it breaks, that it will keep going up in value. And it does scare me a little bit. All major currencies has advanced against the greenback since July. And that's what Pew Pew Pal does, is just prints more of that. And dollar demand weighs as treasury yields. The 10-year, all the yields drop. People go into the bonds, the yields drop, and the economy stumbles. But rather than giving you bad news, because this channel is not just about bad news, it's like, what do we do with this bad news? So let's take a look at the market and see if the dollar is tradable. And you guys are gonna punch me in the face, but here's the only thing that I don't like about this trade. We are under the 200. Let me make myself go bye-bye. Now I am gone, right? We're overbought on the RSI. Let me show you exactly. You're like, oh, it's always nice to show us how to trade after the fact. No, it's pretty much the same thing that I do. One candle close above my 9 and I ride it. So even though I do videos on, oh, the dollar, it's crashing. Well, yeah, it is. But that doesn't mean that there's an opportunity for a trade. And here is your swing trade, right? We come up, we go down. Look at the RSI. Oversold. Everyone's like, get out, run. I wait for a reversal and now we're up. So there we go. That is how I would trade the dollar. And I would actually even consider taking some profits off, right? Because now, again, we are in overbought conditions. This is when everyone's like, oh, it's okay, the dollar. And then it starts swinging back down. You guys can see on the MACD, it's starting to cool off. So that's signaling to me, Johnny Bravo may want to take a few bucks off of the table. And my video last week, I zoomed out for you. I believe that smart money is coming in now. Just think of news as like opposite day. Whatever the news says, do the complete opposite. Or buy things that are cheap. See, like my wife. My wife always buys things when they're on sale. You want to buy things when they're on sale. You want them on sale, but showing signs of strength. You want a reversal. You don't want something that's broken down on the side of the road, like a car. You're like, oh, that's a really nice Lamborghini. That thing's worth at least $300,000. I think I will buy it. Then you pop the hood open, right? That would be your technicals, and it doesn't have an engine. How much is a Lamborghini with no engine that was in a collision? Because then you find out that it had frame damage. I'd say that Lambo is worth about $5. And my last article was going to be from Charles Hugh Smith. I like his blog. The next leg down, the top 10% are about to take a hit. You don't care, right? You're like, good, let them take a hit, and that's okay. I'm not going to go over this story because my daughter wants me to go to lunch with her, and I believe in family, right? You support that? But if you've made it to the very end and you haven't subscribed yet, half of you guys aren't even subscribed. What the frack? Like, let's click the subscribe button. If I made you laugh one time, can you do me a favor? Click that like button, and I will see you tomorrow. Good one, Wolf. Stay tuned.